Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the literary term essay. The word essay is derived from a Latin word exessim, which roughly means presenting one's case or presenting one's ideas. So essays are a short piece of writing representing one's side of the argument or one's experiences, stories, etc. Now this term essay, it has been defined differently in different ages. Like during the Elizabethan age, Francis Bacon defined it as dispersed meditations, which means that it express a man's thought in a disconnected manner. Then in 18th century, Dr. Samuel Johnson defined it as a loose sally of mind, an irregular, indigested piece, not a regular and orderly composition. This definition means that the essayist's mind moves here and there aimlessly or randomly in random manner within the limits of his subject and does not search for depth and profundity, whereas the Oxford English Dictionary defines the essay as a composition of moderate length on any particular subject or branch of a subject, originally implying want of finish, but now said of a composition more or less elaborate in style, though limited in range. Then M.H. Abrams, in his book Literary Terms, defines it in a broader way, and he writes that any brief composition in prose that undertakes to discuss a matter, express a point of view, or persuade us to accept a thesis on any subject whatever. So there are different definitions given by different scholars in different ages, but overall we can summarize with the definition of M.H. Abrams, which he gave in his book Literary Terms, and which is also prescribed in your syllabus in recommended books. Now this word essay, it came into use on the publication in 1580 when Montaigne published his book with the title Essays, but the spelling is E-S-S-A-I-S, so there is a difference. The title signifies, or its meaning is, attempts, and was meant to indicate the tentative and unsystematic nature of Montaigne's discussions in contrast to formal and technical treatises on the same subjects. Later in 16th century, Francis Bacon popularized essay in England, and he published his own series of essays. Here there is a difference in the spelling. He has changed it to E-S-S-A-Y-S. So these essays, or this series of essays, are short comments on subjects of general, means they are subjects which are of, they are general subjects such as of truth, of adversity, of friendship, of travel, etc. Then the other famous essays were, besides Francis Bacon, there was Ben Jonson, Joseph Addison, Richard Steele, Charles Lamb, William Hazlitt, Leo Tolstoy, Ralph Waldo Emerson, George Orwell, Aldous Huxley, T.S. Eliot, and many others. Edison and Steele's journals, Tatler and Spectator, with their many successors, gave to the prose essay its standard modern vehicle, the literary periodical. They published their essays in these periodicals, Tatler and Spectator. Then in the early 19th century, the founding of new types of magazines and their steady proliferation, means publicity, gave great impetus, momentum to the writing of essays and made them a major deportment of literature. And this was the age when Hazlitt, De Quincey and Charles Lamb brought the essay, and especially the personal essay, to a level that has remained unsurpassed. Now, there are certain characteristics of essays. I am going to tell you about those characteristics. Number one, they are short in length, right? Then, an argument based on a topic or subject and contains description, analysis, and clarification. Then, logical consistency is another important characteristic. There should be coherence among sentences and cohesion of paragraphs. Then, personal and subjective. These essays were, when they began, means it when they came into existence as a genre, they were personal and subjective, but Bacon used it as an impersonal and objective tool. So there begins the change. Then, an expression of writer's personality, direct manifestation of writer's views on a subject. And the next characteristic is language of essay is well chosen. The writer is aware of the limitations and he cannot afford more elaboration. So he has to keep this limitation in mind. Then there are different types of essays. Generally, the two broader categories are the formal or impersonal essays and the informal, personal or familiar essays. So, the formal essays are generally academic in nature and tackle serious topics. The author of such essays writes as an authority or like at least as highly knowledgeable about that particular subject. Then in the informal essay or the familiar or personal essay, the author assumes a tone of intimacy with his readers and tries tends to be concerned with everyday things rather than with public affairs or specialized topics, and he writes in a relaxed and a self-revelatory and sometimes even whimsical fashion. So they are more personal and often have humorous elements. Besides these, we have narrative essays. This is when the writer is narrating an incident or story through the essay, and usually they are in the first person, means they are in the first person only. Then we have descriptive essays. In this type of essays, the writer will describe a place, an object, an event, or maybe even a memory. So he just simply describes about something. Then another type of essay is persuasive essays. In this type of essay, the purpose of the essayist is to get the reader to his side of the argument. He tries to convince the reader. A persuasive essay is not just a presentation of facts, but it is also an attempt to convince the reader of the writer's point of view. Then there is another kind, expository essays. Essays written to explore and explain ideas are called expository essays. they expose some kind of truths. Then these, we can say, will be more formal types of essays, usually written in third person. So these are the various types of essays. Besides these, nowadays there are some other types of essays also, like narrative essays. Like we have argumentative essays, then we have certain other types of essays also, depends on the subject of the essay. But the broader categories include the formal, the informal, narrative, descriptive, persuasive and expository essays. So this is certain things which you must know about this literary term, that how it, the term, this word originates, what's the definition of essay, what are the chief characteristics of essay, then types of essays, then names of some famous essays. All these things you must include when you are asked to write a short note on this topic in your exams. So that's all. Thank you.